Hi friends, welcome back. So guys, in this video we will be learning about how to retrieve the data in Laravel for the bootstrap model thing. Okay, so in previous video we have done about bootstrap model with the inserting data. Okay, so we will be inserting data using bootstrap model. That is done now. Okay, so now in this video we will retrieve the data into one table format and edit the data with the model. Okay, so for that first we have to do with the table, guys. So now in previous video we have done one employee model. Okay, so now in this we were till here, right? So like we have created one model, okay, and this was our form, and with that help of with the resource controller we did with it and done and insert the data, right? So now this is my container, this is my heading, okay, and this for the message. Okay, so we will get the output for this message type, and this is was our launching model. Okay, so I mean to add the model, so I'll show you the output. So guys, this is the output now. Okay, the final output right now it is. So we will create a table to retrieve the data in this, then edit with it. So inside my container itself, this is my container start and end, so I'm going to paste inside that one table. Okay, so make sure go to your bootstrap.com. okay, so getbootstrap.com, click on documentation and search for table. Okay, search for table, and now I'm going to copy some nice table. Okay, so I'm going to take this table actually. So guys, I'm just copy it and get back to your code and paste it into your blade file, right? So now what we have to do is that just we have to retrieve the data. So as simple and a clear thing, we'll finish it soon. Okay, so we are not going to take much time in this. So guys, this is our table now. Okay, so first thing is that we will name it to ID and first name. So I have given some contents like same it is. Okay, last name and address of that employee, and finally one more table I needed, table heading, that is one mobile number. Okay, so mobile number, fine. So now we have to enter the data also with it according to it. Okay, so that is right now we don't have the data over here, so we are going to fetch the data and show it over here. So before that I will show you the output of it. So let's go to output and see. So that it is in this format. Okay, so let's just I'll break this line. So let's give a br, yep, so it may be little down. Okay, so now we will make this as add data. Okay, so add data, let's refresh, and it is over here. So if I click add data, the model comes and you can add the data. So that was done in previous video. If you want to know about this, please watch out the previous video. Okay, so now in this we will be doing with the ID thing. Okay, I mean retrieving the data over here, right? So I have used one more class called table border. Okay, so the output looks like this something. So guys, yes, let's get started and we'll retrieve the data now. So guys, this is our first page, right? So like it is the main page. So this is the main page, right? So I'm going to view on that main page is nothing but add the resource controller. Okay, so let's go to our app, HTTP controller and employee controller. Okay, so I have done, and now in to view the output of that main EMP model file. Okay, this blade file, to view that I have used to return view with that. Okay, so I am going to return a data into that file itself. So for that we have to code here itself, like I am going to create one variable called emps is equal to with the model. Okay, so not student, I have used model called employee at a scope resolution, or is to you can say at okay all function. So now this employee, if you are using your model, okay, so I'll tell you now, inside app you have created one model employee.php. okay, so if you are using this employee.php, I mean you are using over here in your controller, so you have to use and at the top. Okay, so inside app folder employee.php, then you can use it. Okay, so done, and now we will return its variable. Okay, so that is emps with the dollar called emps. okay, so comma dollar emps, not with single quotes, just remove that. And actually you have to use with. Okay, you can use with or you can use compact. Okay, so that is called with, or you can use the compact also. Done. So it, let's save this. And to view at your blade file, you have to use for each loop. Okay, so let's use the for each loop. So for each, I'm going to use at for each, and then end for each, right? So when you start for each, and you have to end the for each end, right? And now you are going to create a variable. What you are able to create? So this variable which you have created in your employee, I mean your controller, employee controller. So copy that and paste it over here as whatever, employee data. Okay, so just let's copy this, and according to it you have to paste it. Okay, so let's paste that into single input curly braces data as id. okay, so simple, save. So you can get like this only. Okay, so let's copy this and paste it below it. Okay, so just name this as according to your content f name, right? So let's make it this also. Oops, oh god, what happened? Okay, so I'm going to use this l name, and finally with one more thing, that is address or address, and one more. Okay, so I'm going to copy this td, that is final output with mobile. Okay, so let's save it and make sure your php artisan is served. Okay, so I'm going telling means yeah, this one. Okay, let's close this and let's go for the output, enter, and we have two datas called Ved Prakash Bangalore and this number. Okay, so let me enter one more data. Okay, so that is subscribe funda of web IT. okay, and yep, let it be Bangalore itself, and some data taken by. So let's save this, and it gets saved and the data comes over here, as simple. So guys, now the data is saved also over here. Okay, so there is some dot I think somewhere. Yeah, so this there, let's refresh, and no dot. Okay, so guys, now we have retrieved the data. Now we will be edit the data with the bootstrap model, like how it is popping up, like that we are going to edit the model. Okay, so for that, now let's create one button now itself only. So as simple, I am going to use that one called action, that's it. Okay, action, and So we have one header also, so I will create one footer also. Okay. Yes, so let's create for that. So we are going to use that one footer I'm going to create. Okay, for this, so let's copy that and paste it. Okay, so just change it as simple, nothing we have to do, just change this. Okay, FOOT foot, that's it, done. So let's refresh and you'll get the same thing below it. Okay, so it is done. And now under the action you have to give something called like td. So inside this we are going to create a buttons. Okay, so that will be as simple. So that will be like a link we will use, and just leave it this as simple. Okay, so over here edit, right? And now we will give a bootstrap classes for the design, like btn primary, or we'll give su ccess success, and some other class also you can give for that. Okay, so yeah, so it's fine for this now. And now let me give one more button called delete. Okay, so btn danger I will give, that will be delete, delete. And yeah, so let's see the output of it. Yeah guys, so finally you have got this. Now if I click on delete, edit, so the model should pop up like this and edit the data. Okay, and next we'll delete it. Okay guys, so guys, in this video that's it. And you have learned how to fetch the data. Okay, and now in next video we'll be learning about edit the data. So guys, please subscribe the channel, please like the video, share the video, and thank you for watching this video guys. Thank you once again.